There is definitely a future for organic solar cells in the industry. I don't think that I can think of any other solar cell technology that can be made as cheap and is in as large a scale as organic solar cells. My name is Mikkel Jørgensen, and I'm a senior scientist at the Technical University of Denmark. We do roll coating, roll-to-roll coating in a large scale of organic solar cells. So that means that we have developed a huge amount of techniques for moving this scientific field from pure science and small devices into something more industrially related and useful. I think there is still a lot of unresolved questions in organic solar cells that could occupy scientists for a long time onwards. There are many unresolved issues in creating more efficient solar cells, more stable solar cells. But certainly the field is moving, and we have tried to be a part of that and move this from glass substrates into something more useful, such as our solar park, where we have installed many hundreds of meters of length of solar cell generating thousands of volts. The course was very different from a normal classroom teaching experience, in that you can now reach thousands or even tens of thousands of students. Yeah, I took part in the Coursera course as a lecturer. It was a great surprise, actually. I didn't realize that so many people were interested in organic solar cells. So it's a huge and interesting thing to witness that kind of new kind of learning system. I think the concept of having internet type conferences is great, because I think you can reach many more people with this technique also. People do not need to travel to a conference to see the lecture, and they can do it at the pace they want. There are some negative sides to e-courses and e-learning in general, and that is that you do not get an immediate response from the people that you are talking to and with. I'm going to talk about LPIC in connection with organic solar cells and the advances that we have made in this subject. The LPIC technology for studying solar cells has been around for a long time, since I think the late 70s or so, and it was inherently a very slow technique that could be used in discrete cases for solar cells, because it took something like a day to acquire an image of a reasonably sized solar cell. And our motivation is, of course, that we need an instrument that can be compatible with the roll-to-roll production speed of, say, 10 meters per minute. So we needed something much faster.